you love me, please don't judge me. Got my hands tied, the power's above me. Don't shoot the messenger, I'm just a puppet here. If you wanna place blame, then look to the puppeteer. Family, fortune, envy, jealousy, privilege, passed on, legacy, secret, sabotage, borderline, felony, suicide, subtract, selfish, pedigree, yeah.
How's it going, everybody? C-Rad TV back here in our video, and welcome to C-Rad TV vlog number 44. So, of course, for today's vlog, we're heading down to Oswegan Speedway to the Penny Series race at Oswegan for the Dirt Classic. This one, the Freshstone Dirt Classic, the Oswegan Dirt Doubleheader for the Penny Series. As the Penny Series is getting close to the end of the season, as the championship battle heats up between Marc-Antoine Cameron and Trane Lapcevich. So, we're getting ready to head down there to the track. Going to be a night race, so we'll be there in time to see the heats and probably some practice, too. A lot of dirt rainers in the races this weekend, too, including Ken Schrader and Stuart Friesen. Of course, Schrader, a former Cup Series driver, and Stuart Friesen, a Truck Series driver. So, yeah, that'll be cool to see them again. But, yeah, getting ready to go. Got the Cameron pit shirt on. So, yeah, the first vlog in a week, since we're still fresh off the vlogs from Michigan a week ago. And yes, I did watch the Indianapolis race the other day. But yeah, getting ready to go. We're heading out a little bit. But yeah, see you out the car when it's time. All right, we're officially on the road to Oswegan. We got a 2-hour drive ahead of us. Let's go. All right, here we are at Oswego Speedway for night one of the dirt doubleheader. Let's go in.
Closed when the caution period is called. Do not race back.
Chevrolet, it's Daniel Wong. The driver that had the biggest handful was Stuart Friesen in the 19, but he's already trying to make it.
Hey. Up the corner. Scheduled 10 lap distance.
Expect. He wasn't here last year, but he's got a quick car.
Tell you what I like about him. He is so relaxed. He is just here to have a good time. Talk to him before the race. Green flag, and that will be your lead. Lapsovic to sneak out front.
And on the hill he goes, down the back stretch.
Had a head of steam going off of turn number two. He's going to do it again in three and four. Right up to the diamond.
Throw to yellow.
They'll bring out the yellow.
He's been impressive in this qualifying heat. It's been all Trayton Lapsovic as Rogue. Where's Ranger going?
What the hell?
There might have been worse, I shouldn't say. But it's the ugliest one I've seen.
Wow.
Who ran the wall?
A bear slammed it hard on the back stretch.
To green.
And to the outside, DJ Kennington, Kevin went along out in the second spot.
fighting to do to get up to the high side. Mark Antoine Camoyan down low, pitches that 96 sideways, comes on. We look at our ice racers in the field, Andrew Ranger and LP Dimlin. The GM Paillet, Chevrolet Canada, number 01, David Hebert. Number 2, in the GSR, Oshawegan Speedway, Chanterelli Chevrolet, number 0, Glenn Stiers. First, from Trois-Rivières, Quebec, the WeatherTech OmniFab Dodge, number 47, L.P. Dumoulin. From St. Leonard to Aston, Quebec, the GM Paillet, Chevrolet Canada, number 96, Marc-Antoine Cameron. The Assa Abloy, Fast Eddie, HGC Chevrolet, number 3, Alex Gannett. Stainer, Ontario, the Leland Industries, GMS, RGC Sheer Metal Products Chevrolet number 9, Brandon Watson. Eleven, from Roxton Pond, Quebec, the GM Paillet, Chevrolet Canada number 27, Andrew Ranger. Anawagi, Quebec, the Recap Recovery Drink Bullies Truck Stop Chevrolet number 92, Dexter Stacy. Seven, from Sprakers, New York, the Glenn Stiers Racing Chevrolet number 19, Stuart Friesen. Eustache, Quebec, the Gates Hydraulics, Napa Auto Parts Dodge, number 74, Kevin Lacroix. Lachine, Quebec, the St. Hubert NTN Bearings, Quick Genetech Chevrolet, number 18, Alex Taglioni. Third, from St. Thomas, Ontario, the Super Clean Castrol Edge Spark Powered Dodge number 17, DJ Kennington. Side of row number 1, in the GSR, FBM Delta Bingo and Gaming, RGC Chevrolet number 20, Trayton Lopsevich. And on the pole, from Fenton, Missouri, the APC Auto Parts Center's Federated Auto Parts Pennzoil Chevrolet number 22, Kenny Schrader.
Yeah!
Yeah. Oh, we are, oh, we are, the holy.
Start your engine!
22. We're heading back to green. It is the final. Thank you.
They will celebrate down in victory lane. Our Clinton Jeffrey will pick up.
And just have a look through the stack.
Scored the victory in the Freshstone 100. I asked you before the race if it was the car or the driver. Are you willing to concede that maybe you had some input in this?
I just drove it. You know, these guys, the whole 22 team, Kyle being the crew chief, they gave me an excellent car. My teammate there in the 20 car, you know, we were working good together, and then he got in the left car and I said, together, and definitely want to thank ATV for letting us do this. You know, they're the reason for us.
Congratulations, Ken Schrader is over here. Give him a speech. Zaco. That's a good Navajo Zaco. So if you're back tomorrow, get the stuff and the strawberry.
Back out the car, we're getting ready to leave and head out from Oswegan for night one. So yeah, Ken Schrader got the win, first time in Penny Series history that a non-Canadian driver wins a Penny's race. So history made tonight. Talk more about the race when I get home. We got a 2-hour drive back home. I'll talk to you some when I get back. Alright, so I'm back home now. So this is all what I got at the track for night one. So I got this shirt for free in the pit area, because I believe this is like Aaron Turkey's a sponsor for the race. And this one, I bought the shirt. It's the Oswegan Speedway shirt for both races for a doubleheader, the Freshstone Dirt Classic tonight, and then tomorrow the Penny's 100. And on the back of the sign's really cool right there. And of course, this doubleheader will also culminate in the 200th Penny race in the Penny Series, which I'm actually surprised we're at 200 races. Like, I was like, Jesus, we're at 200 races already? It's crazy how much time has flown by fast. You know, it won't be long until they're at 300 and then 400 and 500 and so on. But yeah, anyway, back home now. So yeah. So yeah, Oswegan, it was a really good race. A lot better. It wasn't a shit show like last year's race in Oswegan was. Like, this race is a lot better. Better officiating too. And there was even at near the end a threat for rain, because the start time for this race got moved up nearly 50 minutes because of rain and potentially in the area. But despite it, the rain didn't come until like probably 40 minutes after the race. Like, the rain didn't really, we didn't really hit any rain on the way home until like around 12:30. Tampa. Yeah, like filming this now, it's like nearly 1:30 in the morning right now. So yeah, just getting ready to go to sleep. But yeah, you know, race one was a banger. You know, and Ken Schrader makes Penny Series history, because I actually didn't know this about this until like about maybe as I was leaving the track. Ken Schrader not only does become the first foreign driver to win in the Penny Series, and before anyone asks, yes, for the Penny, in terms of Penny Series, Schrader is technically foreign, because it's a Canadian series, and Schrader is not Canadian, he's American. So yeah, first time a foreign-born driver wins in a series based in Canada. Not only that, Schrader also becomes the oldest driver to win a race in the Penny Series at over 68 years old. Too bad it wasn't 69 years old, because we could have made so many fucking memes with that. Yeah, smashing the previous record set by Donald Teague in 2018 when Teague was the previous oldest winner in the series at 52 years old. Hey, I guess for some people, age is only a number. But yeah, Ken Schrader, the old bastard, still got it. But yeah, I was actually surprised when I saw Schrader's age. I did not know Schrader was 68. I thought Schrader was a lot younger than that, but damn. But damn, I guess age truly is a number after all. But yeah, that was race one, and race two will be tomorrow night. Maybe tomorrow night, it's because there's a high chance it's going to rain most of the day. If not tomorrow night, it will probably be Wednesday, sometime Wednesday. You know, because the rain date, I'm not sure if it goes to Wednesday, if it's going to be a day race or a night race. Because the dust clouds from the cup from these Penny Series cars aren't as big as the ones we've seen from the cup cars on dirt. So they might be able to race in the daytime. I mean, they ran the heats in the daytime. You know, we'll have to see what happens when we get there. But yeah, anyway, that'll wrap it up here. That's all I gotta say. I'll see you all in the vlog for the next vlog, which will be the Tuesday night race, the Penny's 100. But yeah, that was the Fresh Stone Dirt Classic at Oswego. See y'all later. I'm out.